Welcome to the Barker Podcast Collection.
Welcome to the Not Watching Podcast. My name's Rob Howard, and this week I'm joined by
Ian Bruce
and Marcus Hurley.
You can contact us on email at notwatchingpodcast@gmail.com or follow us on Twitter at notwatchingpod. Okay, so yeah, got a full year of TV ahead of us, and just going to talk about some of the stuff we're looking forward to.
Oh yeah, let's talk about this. Okay.
So right off the top, Netflix have announced that they're going to be doubling their original programming in 2016, and my god, there's a whole bunch of stuff coming through that pipe now, and especially now that they, well, at CES last week they launched internationally in 130 more countries, so there's no stopping this juggernaut. So yeah, straight off the bat, we've got new seasons of House of Cards, we've got the second season of Daredevil, and also they just dropped a couple of trailers for some brand new shows. Did you see either of these? One of them's called The Crown.
Down to Manny Station's, homeboy.
Dearly beloved.
Seems the country's split down the middle. Half's furious. We're not free to choose our partners like anyone else.
No one wanted Philip. She dug her heels in, got the man she wanted, didn't she?
We have a new sovereign, young, and a woman. Let us give her a coronation that is befitting of the wind of change that she represents, modern and forward-looking.
Be firm, just lay down the law. I know he's Winston Churchill and all that, but remember who you are. You're
nobody.
The Queen of England.
Why was government not consulted?
Because it's a private matter.
Nothing you or His Royal Highness does is a private matter.
Do not look for perfection in him or in yourself.
Winston still thinks he's the father of the nation.
Let's not forget that times are changing. Morality is changing. Country is changing.
And one has to ask oneself, what is the purpose of the crown? What is the purpose of the monarchy? The decision is yours to make.
You've taken my career from me, you've taken my home, you've taken my name. What kind of marriage is this? What kind of family?
Are you my wife or my queen?
I'm both.
I want to be married to my wife.
I am both, and a strong man will be able to kneel to both.
I will not kneel before my wife.
But your wife is not asking you to.
But my queen commands me.
Yes.
I beg you, make an exception for me.
No.
Who wants transparency? Then you can have magic. Who wants prose when you can have poetry?
That's why we have family. To be links in a chain that can never be broken.
Pull away the veil, and what are you left with? An ordinary young woman of modest ability and little imagination. But wrap her up like this, anoint her with oil, and hey presto. What do you have? A goddess.
I'm Philip, Duke of Edinburgh. Become your liege man of life and limb and of earthly worship. And faith and truth I will bear unto you to live and die against all manner of folks. So help me God.
Two rings. Two marriages. Two lives.
The Crown looks like, well, it basically seems to be about young Queen Elizabeth II, and it's got like an amazing cast. You've got Doctor Who bloke, what's his name, Matt Smith, he's okay. Playing Philip.
Doctor Who bloke.
Yeah, and in an genius bit of casting, this John Lithgow as Churchill.
Wow.
Yeah. So, and it looks lavish. It looks like the sort. Looks like the trailer for like the King's Speech or something. It's all like big hall, palace halls, and you know, horse and carts everywhere, and loads of extras.
Cool.
Looks like insane high production value. I've got a list here. I can keep going. But are you guys got anything you're looking forward to next year?
X-Files.
In 2002, our investigation ceased, but my personal obsession did not.
He said if I ever put the pieces together, you would confirm.
You're close.
Our work is the key to everything.
I can't do this alone.
Yeah.
I'm here.
They police us and spy on us. Tell us that makes us safer.
We've never been in more danger.
And do something about it, Mulder.
This is my life. This is everything I believe in.
You are on dangerous ground here.
I know what I'm doing.
Yeah, that's very soon. Isn't it?
24th is
February.
That's January, I think, in the States.
Is it? Oh, yeah, it 25th. Popped up. I thought it came. Oh, wow.
Hold on.
Yeah, I think it's like
January
a
24th.
They're doing. Yeah, and 25th, they're doing like over two nights. Consecutive nights.
Is that all six or just the first two?
No, first two episodes, and then it'll be like for it's only six episodes, yeah. So that should be good. I wonder how. Hopefully, they're not both too creaky. Seen Gillian Anderson in loads of stuff recently.
Jesus.
Yeah.
Single two at the moment, apparently.
Yeah, because that's going to happen, isn't it? Now they're all empowered. Jesus.
One can dream. Yeah. Have you got anything, Marcus?
Mr. Robot, season two, maybe.
Luke Cage is this year as well, apparently.
Yep. Yeah, Daredevil, season two.
Yep.
Obviously more Game of Thrones.
Yeah, they just announced the date for that. It's April.
Funny enough, I'm something actually other. Looking forward to more Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. Because I went back and I started watching more of it, got through all of the slog, and it actually picked up and became a semi-decent series. I find it more enjoyable than Arrow, which is saying
something. Was that
season
two that picked up?
No, it's on... God knows what season it's on there.
I think it's halfway through season three, I think, at this
stage. Yeah, it's been on TV and stuff.
So when did it pick up? Was that season three that it picked up, or season two that it picked up? How far do I have to watch before it gets good?
Probably near the end of season two, think. Something happened, and it's kind of, I don't know, some stuff happened with the characters. But it seems to be spearheading its way back into the Marvel world, because of the way that they can't call mutants anymore. And they're all, I can't remember what the term is now, inhumans.
God.
Because Fox owned the mutant name.
Okay.
So in the film world, they can't call it that. It's ridiculous.
Right.
It is ridiculous. I won't go on anymore about it. I could go on forever.
I'm sure I read something today saying that they were going to do a spin-off of that as something else.
What? Oh, yeah. There is two of the characters in there. They're going to get a spin-off show, which I think is a mistake, because the show's only just started to properly get his legs and it's actually making a bit more sense. It's actually gotten a lot darker. Funny enough, one of the characters, Ward, he is probably one of the best on-screen bad guys I've seen in a while, because he's just evil. He just doesn't care. He actually just does stuff because he wants to. It's like Hydra's a broken mess and he just took it over and he's just like, well... it's mine now.
Cool.
Which, I mean, it's a guilty pleasure, and I've kind of just like watching it, but I'm actually looking forward to it. There's been a nice little reveal at the end of the break between the seasons, so I'm waiting for it to come back. And he's pretty much just leveled up, so he's gone from being bad guy to uber bad guy. And it's also linking back as well to, a lot of the stuff that might pop up in some of the Avengers films and all that. So it seems like they're trying to make an effort to get back into it. But who knows what's going to happen in these films, and maybe they'll be left reeling again, you know, a la the Winter Soldier.
Yeah, I'm sure
which
there's
going to
be some...
Which is why I think that series suffered. Because everything they tried to build basically got destroyed.
Kind of had the rug pulled from underneath them, didn't they?
With
the events of the cinematic stuff.
That, and it was way too cheesy for its own good. But
they'll probably
back.
Drop a bomb on them with Civil War as well, that they'll have to... recover from.
Well, to be honest, by the time they kind of get round to, if it's still going by 2019, 2020, I don't think that anything will be going on beyond that.
No. Yeah, apocalyptic stuff. One of my resolutions this year is to try and catch up with Peaky Blinders. It's this third season that they're filming at the moment is due on in April, and it's got Tom Hardy in it as well. So it's almost like a Christopher Nolan movie reunion. They've got Sam Neill's in there as well. It's supposed to be really good. They're only like 6-episode runs as well, so it should be fairly doable. Season 1's on Netflix. Hopefully season 2 will be on there as well before season 3 airs on the BBC. But yeah, that's like a period sort of gangster thing and widely regarded to be one of the best sort of British exports, you know, going. Okay. So going to try and do that. Fourth and final season of Banshee I'm looking forward to, as I've said elsewhere before, maybe after this, I don't know.
Westworld?
Yeah, there's no date for that yet. That's definitely on my list. I reckon it's going to be like later on in the year, like maybe after Game of Thrones or something.
Yeah.
I reckon. There's another HBO show called Vinyl as well that looks quite interesting with Bob Cannavale. I think that's how you pronounce his name. He was in Boardwalk Empire, and he's popped up in a few films and stuff as well.
And this miniseries with James Franco based on the Spielberg... The Spielberg? Jesus, I need to go to bed. Based on the Stephen King book, 11/22/63, about the assassination of Kennedy.
I'm going to tell you something. It's going to seem crazy. I need you to go in this closet, take a look around, then I'll tell you everything. That was 1960. I need you to go back there to prevent the assassination of John F. Kennedy.
From out of town, am I right?
You shouldn't be here.
Yes, I had my life.
I don't know whether Oswald was the man who did it. You'll figure out the rest when you get there.
You see, the past doesn't want to be changed.
When you're close to changing something, you feel it push back.
Last thing you can say about killing a man is that it's brave.
Mr. Amberson, this is Miss Stunhill.
She's starting off.
When rules are broken, there's a price.
Price must be paid. Things right.
CIA's pulling the trigger. What do we do now?
Then you kill Oswald.
Everything you say is a lie.
A little bit of time travel? Time travel? Oh, Jesus. He's working us. Help, we're trapped.
I will release you soon. It's
wow.
Yeah, I like the time travel device is a wardrobe. It's very Narniary.
Very Narniary.
Narniary, if that's a word. Narniary.
Yeah.
Got more Vikings. I'll probably be watching that. More Better Call Saul. More Black Sails. Probably going to watch that. Last season was excellent. Mostly on account of me watching it in two sittings. That always helps, I find. What else? I'm sure there was something else. Oh, Preacher.
What do you want, kid?
It's about my dad. I want you to hurt him.
You know it's a sin just to ask me that.
I know. People said before you were a preacher, you did things.
How hurt you want him? How far do I go? Problem is, your daddy's a big fella. He's gonna fight back. Things will escalate. That's what these things do, they escalate. Violence makes violence. Makes nothing much at all.
Preacher! Enough!
Almost done, Sheriff. Is that what you want, kid? Jesus, what kind of a preacher are you?
I read a news story today, because I think it's the... There's some kind of TV festival going on at the moment, and they screened the pilot, and the writer said it's very, very different to the comic.
Hmm.
But I think people who are into this sort of thing will still enjoy it, which sort of worries me. I'm not going to go back and read the comics now, because I feel like if I do, I'm going to be disappointed. Yeah. So I just wonder how much they're going to lose, because they've still got that. They still say like there's a supernatural event.
Hmm.
They've still got vampires in it, or a vampire in it, and it's still ultra violent. And Arseface is in it, so I don't know how they can fuck it up really.
Maybe we won't see like the birth of the Word of God or something like that. Or
yeah, I don't know if I'll be bothered by that because we've already seen that in Jessica Jones now. So. Because he's got a very similar power to Kilgrave.
Exactly, yeah. I'm looking at the article now that you've linked to. And apparently they said, yeah, everyone involved felt that they shouldn't translate it directly from the comic. And then in the article they put, including comic creator Garth Ennis. So if he himself has kind of hinted that maybe they shouldn't do a translation, a literal, do a Watchmen, essentially. And slavishly... It's going to piss John off, though.
Yeah, possibly so, especially as he's catching up on it again. But I think some of the stuff in the comic is a bit batshit.
Hmm.
So it might be for the best. I mean, Seth Rogen's a fan. They're obviously fans of the show, of the comic, sorry. So you have to think that any changes they've made have been for the benefit of the show. But whether it's going to be... I don't know, but hopefully it can just be its own thing and it'll be fine. But it's such a great comic, it really is. Yeah. You've got to ask why, if they're not adapting it properly, why bother? But I don't know. Cool, okay. Anyone got anything else?
No. Only a design. That's plenty, right, actually.
That's plenty of TV to be looking forward to that we'll probably never find time to watch all of anyway. This has been the Not Watching Podcast in partnership with notlistening.co.uk, where you can also hear myself and Ian talk about video games and virtual reality on the Not Playing Podcast, and Adam, Ash and Will talk about all manner of funny things on the Not Listening Podcast. You can email us at notwatchingpodcast@gmail.com, or you can tweet at or follow us on Twitter at notwatchingpod. You can find the show notes for this show at notlistening.co.uk, and if you're listening to us on iTunes, then please do give us a review. Anyway, that's all for now. Thanks for listening. See ya.
Bye.
Get down on it. Come on and get down on it. Get down on it. While you're dancing.